Tacoma Nanny Tech we actually need. Do you guys want this stuff? Everybody, how are you today? Pretty good here. That's right. There is some Toyota Tacoma Nanny Tech that we actually need. Now, first of all, what is Nanny Tech or Nanny Technology? Those are all the little things, either software or additions to the Tacoma that are supposed to help us out, to aid us in our driving experience, either for convenience or to make the experience more safe. Now, there are a lot of things that I don't like. I did a video about that, but there are some things that we should have, I think, that would be convenient, that would be nice to have. Number one, rain sensing wipers. I love rain sensing wipers. You know, I've had them in other vehicles before, and if you're not familiar with them, they are exactly what the name says, right? If you put it to the setting, and there's usually a couple sensitivity levels, right? So you set it where you want it, you're out cruising around, it starts to rain. You don't have to screw with the windshield wipers. They just automatically come on. And I know it's a simple thing, right? I mean, how hard is it to flip the switch? But hey, how hard is it to change your cruise control settings? You know, we have that automatic cruise control thing, adaptive cruise control, automatic headlights, all that stuff. Kind of along the same vein as that. A heads-up display. That is an awesome feature. And I would argue it's kind of a safety feature too. It keeps your eyes more pointed down the road. Of course, the heads-up display is when the speedometer or any other information that you might want, maybe fuel level, is actually projected on the screen in kind of one of those see-through display features right in front of you while you're driving down the road. Now, of course, I don't mean that it's right in your line of sight. Typically, it's off to the left or it's low on the screen. But it's an awesome feature, and it can't cost that much money to add. I mean, let's get rid of something we don't want, like the TSS system. Programmable remote start climate control. Now, what I'm talking about, and I mentioned this in another video, or something alluding to it, you know, right now with the Tacoma, if you want the climate inside to be set, you kind of have to set it up before you leave, right? So for instance, if it's, I don't know, really warm outside, and when you hit your remote start, you want the air conditioning and everything to fire up, you have to go ahead and set that before you get out. I would rather have something in the system, and this is very simple to do, I would think, with all the software out these days, you just set it to the temperature that you want on your system, right? Within the remote start feature. I'm not talking about just setting the temperature, you know, like you use normally. I'm talking about a remote specific setting so that when you get in the truck, it's where you want it to be, irregardless of what the existing setting was in the truck. So you don't have to screw with it. For instance, if you had it turned off, there's a cold front coming, you're working all day. By the time you come out, it's freezing outside, and you wish it would have automatically come on to the setting that you program. No reason why they can't do that. Spare tire TPMS, tire pressure monitoring system. You know, we have the TPMS system already, of course, on all of the active tires that are being used, but none of them ever include the spare tire. And the spare tire is a pain to check, right? I mean, they always put it in the wrong way. You know, the little valve is pointing up. So if you want to check your spare tire pressure, you got to get out the jack, wheel that thing down, crawl under the truck. I mean, it's a drag, man. Why don't we have a spare tire readout on the screen? It makes no sense to me. It's like they just leave it off. I don't know if that's because today the tire has to be rotating in order for the system to read it. I don't know, but certainly they could put something in the spare tire that actually provides a readout on your screen so that you know what the pressure is. I mean, there would be nothing worse than having a flat tire somewhere, right? You pull over, you know you've got a spare, no big deal. You get everything out, you jack the truck up, you wheel the spare tire down, and it's flat. I mean, come on, this is a pretty simple thing. And nobody does it that I know of, except maybe the higher end manufacturers. But I don't know of anybody that does that. Proximity unlock. This is another feature that I really love. And yeah, you don't need it. You can whip out the fob and hit the button, in my case, because I have a manual. You can touch the door lock and open the door. But it's just one of those little extra added things, right? Now, what I'm talking about, you should be able to set the distance, right? Typically, it's only about 2 or 3 feet anyway. But when you're walking up to the truck, maybe you have your hands full. I don't know. Wouldn't it be nice if when you get within some distance to the truck, it automatically unlocks? And you can set it to whichever doors you want it to unlock, right? For safety concerns, it doesn't mean that every door has to unlock. Maybe it's only the driver's door. Or you could set it for all four if you have a family or whatever. But wouldn't that be a cool feature? And it certainly should be simple to do, right? I mean, you can touch the door and have it open. Why doesn't it just recognize the fob in your pocket and unlock when you walk up, however you have it set? That would be an awesome little nanny feature, I think. Lastly, side tailgate opening. Now, what I'm talking about currently with the Tacoma, you only have one option, right? You grab the handle at the top and it pulls down, which is great and all, but how do you get in the bed? You know, if you do what I do, you kind of turn around, put your hands on the bed, lift yourself up, and then turn around and crawl up. Wouldn't it be cool to have the option to open it sideways? Then you could step on the bumper. I mean, they give you a step on the bumper, right? That little cutout area that's kind of an area for you to step on. I happen to have the beaver tail thing on mine right now, that step that sticks out. Wouldn't it be cool if you could just open it sideways? I mean, and Honda has that. I did a video recently. They have the side opening tailgate. Toyota could certainly do that. It's more of a matter of convenience. It also allows you to get closer into the bed, right? I mean, when you open the tailgate, you're increasing the distance from you to the truck by this far, whatever the width of the tailgate is, right? It'd be nice to have access right into the bed, wouldn't it? Just another one of those little simple things that could easily be done. Others are doing it. There's no reason why Toyota couldn't do it as well. Anyway, leave a comment. Let me know what you think about these things. And I know some of them may be a little frivolous, but who cares? I'm paying for this truck. I want it the way I want it. Let me know. What do you think of these? And are there any others that I've left out that you would like to have? Also, real quick, if you're interested, I have two other channels. Rob Motive JT, all about my 2020 Jeep Gladiator. And Rob Motive Civic, all about my adventures with the Honda Civic Sport Hatch and the Honda Civic Type R. Check them out. If you like them, please subscribe. Don't forget to click that notification bell so that you don't miss out on any upcoming videos. And do me a favor, smash that subscribe button on the way out. Thanks for watching. Stay safe out there. Bye.